So Big G, what do you remember when Robert was born?
¿Qué recuerdos tienes cuando Robert nació?
I was going to die. Me iba a morir, ¿verdad?
Así iba a morir.
Why? ¿Cómo es?
From an infection. ¿Es una infección?
¿Qué pasó?
El doctor recetó una medicina, a la farmacia y la recetaron yo creo mal o la farmacia la preparó mal. Era una bebida leche.
Yeah, they said the doctor subscribed a medicine. My dad bought it at the pharmacy, and I think the medicine was either bad or they gave me the wrong medicine. That that's what caused me.
And what happened?
That all my insides. Like glue, like if I drank glue.
That's crazy. You were the oldest, no, the second kid, right?
No, I was the fifth.
You were the fifth?
No, six.
No, I thought five. Danny, then five. You.
Oh, we got four sisters.
So they knew what to do.
Huh?
They knew what to do in emergency.
No, que eso con el ahí cuando pasó eso. Back to the hospital.
And what happened?
10 days.
Wow, that's crazy.
And then I went to the hospital and I was there for 14 days in the hospital.
Did the Big G beat up the doctor? But that was here in America, right? But you're
Carson. Carson.
But 10 days you healed, that's amazing. Because babies, you know, they don't have any immune system really.
10 days, and then I got the medicine. Then for 14 days I was in the hospital. After that, yeah. Oh, that people actually told me, you know, that he could sue the hospital. But my dad, my dad said that he just prayed for me to get better, and that there would be no...
If your dad knew Frank the Tank back then, guaranteed lawsuit.
Yeah. So my dad said, no, as long as my son gets better, then there's no...
Am I right?
It was pretty expensive, too.
Wow.
You didn't have insurance, so you paid everything out of pocket.
Dad, I never knew this.
You paid everything.
That's crazy, Big G. I never knew this.
And I think, ¿qué no usted dijo? I think my dad said that. Usted dijo que en un momento usted quería llevarme a México.
Sí, cuando llegué allí, que estaba bien grave, todavía no te ponía la atención. Y yo le hablé al doctor, al médico, que me atendió a su mamá. Le dije, doctor, y él es el que había recetado la medicina. Y doctor, está muy malo mi niño, y yo aquí no les tengo mucha confianza. Y yo estoy pensando en darle para Tijuana, a curarlo en Tijuana. Y me dijo, no comete ese error. Ahorita por suerte me acabo de informar, sería para darme el ánimo o seguir así viviendo. Lo acabo de informar allá al hospital donde lo tiene, y está el mero grande del hospital. Era como el que domina todo aquí en el hospital. Digo, está el mero, ¿sí cómo lo nombró él? Digo, un especialista muy, muy grande. Digo, si usted se va con su niño, a medio camino se le muere.
But that says that, you know, because
what happened,
he went and talked to the doctor that gave him birth, you know, and told him, look, I don't really trust you guys anymore. I'm going to take him to Mexico, to Tijuana. And then he told him, there's a great specialist right there in the hospital that's really good. So if you take him to Mexico, you know, you're not going to make it to Tijuana before your son is dead. So my dad believed him.
Dijo, firme los papeles que le pidan, digo, porque está con un especialista muy grande.
So sign whatever you have to sign and leave him here, because he's with good doctors. So my dad did, and
But can I tell you why I think there would be better baby doctors in Tijuana? Because there's so many babies, they have much more experience than high-end specialists that see, you know what I mean? Because you have need so much money to see a specialist.
Yeah, but
they're not going to recognize.
The doctor my dad is like, he won't make it. He won't make it to Tijuana. So it's
not yeah.
3-hour drive. So told my dad, he's not going to make it.
But after that, Big G, Robert was healthy his whole childhood, no problem.
Because I hit up and he was still saludable, right? Yeah, I've never had it.
And what age did you know that he does a lot of jokes?
I don't do jokes.
Yeah, you do. You have a good sense of humor, right, Mikey?
Oh. You got my grandma?
Oh, yeah. I got my grandma sick.
How?
Like last year. I started losing some weight. So I went to visit her.
She's 97 years old.
Well, she was 96 then.
Whatever.
So I get to my grandma's house. And she tells me, why are you so skinny? Because I was losing weight. I was exercising and eating healthy. And then I tell her, oh, you don't know, Grandma? You didn't know that? I haven't told you? I'm very sick. I'm gonna die pretty soon.
I started crying.
She was sick for like 2 weeks. Yeah, papa, me treats him for a couple of semanas, eh? When yo le dije que estaba malo, I fucked up. Oh yeah, she was gonna go to Mexico like that same weekend, and she wanted to cancel her flight and everything. And my sister Jackie told us that she would wake up in the middle of the night. Jackie, are you sure Robert's okay? I fucked up. I should have never.
I was right. He has a good sense of humor.
That's not a good sense of humor. That's in a dick. I fucked up.
That's like a big time prank.
I used to joke around with my grandpa too. Remember? Rest in peace, my grandpa. My dad's dad. We used to sit down and talk, and he would ask me, you know, like he was in, you know, he was old and. So I would joke around with him, and he would ask me how work was, like how's work going, and I would start saying, oh, it's tough, picking strawberries. It's very tough, and like, oh, but if that's what you do, that's good. If you're making enough money, you know, to feed your family, that's all that matters. Oh yeah, it's hard, you know, those hot days. I'm really having a hard time, but, you know, picking strawberries or construction, I would just make up stuff. And, you know, we would have a good conversation, and he would give me advice.
He believed it.
He believed it. So
I remember when I asked your grandmother, what do you do for a living? She says, whatever you do, you're up to no good.
So then this weekend we went to Tijuana.
But Big G also went.
Yeah, Big G, but my wife went to the doctor just to get a regular checkup. Because, you know, my dad has a really good doctor over there that my dad really trusts. So we're like, fuck it, you know, might as well get a, you know, so we call the doctor. So when they call Carla in, it's me and her. Me and her, we walk in. He told us the result. Everything was good, no problem, everything. But before he told her to leave her his office, his little room, he told me to go get the license plate to the car so he could give us the pass to come in the fast lane. So I come out and there's my mom and my dad and Chabela and Alvin, and that's the reason I didn't say it. Because of Chabela. I seen Chabela, and I was gonna say, oh, then, you know, we gotta take it to emergency. I was gonna say something like that. But I didn't.
You didn't want to traumatize your daughter.
My daughter would have fucking screamed right away. I said, we gotta take it to emergency. This is really bad.
Saturday.
I'm a dick.
Saturday, I went to go get my challenger at the dealership. After service. And George came from us. I told him to meet me there, and then we'll go to the rack. I had to talk to my kids. Yeah. So we go there, Django gets out, and Fatima comes over to me. I'm getting the car, and then we come this way. So we get to the rack, I get off, and Django's asleep in the car, in the back seat. So I get out, whatever. Fatima's getting out of the car, George getting out of his car, and I tell Fatima, hey, so they get Django out, so we can get him his squad. I knew he was already asleep, but I'm playing it off like he wasn't with me. He's like, Django, you do? I'm like, no. I'm like, I sent him to you. I'm like, well, what do you mean? I'm like, at the dealership, I sent him over to you. And she started crying. Like, Dad, you left Jack with the dealership! And Fatima was like,
see, Mike can play jokes like you do!
No, where? Are you kidding me? Where's he? So Ryu runs to the car. He's in the backseat, he can't tell. He's like, abajo, he can't see it. So he only sees the front seat, he's like, Mom, he's not here! So then they really fell for it. And she started crying. And then I told him, I'm scared, he's asleep.
See, if I can play jokes too.
But I just,
is that just me?
What are you gonna say at the end of the day? You're gonna play jokes. Stop. A couple days ago. What was it? You were in